In this video, we're going to have a look at partial derivatives. So we've seen differentiation as it normally works when we have y's in terms of x's. Okay, so here we've got a function of x here, and y is equal to that function of x. So y only depends there on the value of x. But of course, we can also have formulae where one variable, so for example, a variable v here will depend on the value of both r and h. Okay, so this is the formula for a cylinder. Okay, and you can do the same thing, of course, with the volume of a cone and so on. So here we've got then V, which relies on both R and H changing. Now, when we're finding a derivative of something in this form, of course, we're seeing how Y changes as X changes. Okay, so we're getting the rate of change of Y as X changes. Now here, the volume of a cylinder, of course, can change depending on the radius, and it can also change depending on the height. So there's two aspects here that can change how the volume of a cylinder changes. Now, in terms of pure algebra, we can say that z can change with respect to x's and y's. Okay, so for example, something like this. Okay, so we've seen, of course, our sets of axes x and y when we've been looking at normal derivatives, where we've got y equals, say, x squared. Of course, here now, this will be a 3D plane. Yes, so z depends on x's and y's. So sometimes you see things like saddle-shaped volumetric graphs. So what we can say then is z, the rate of change of z, is dependent upon the changes of x and the changes of y. Now, how do we write this down in terms of derivatives? Well, what we can say is we can differentiate this z with respect to x, and we can also differentiate it with respect to y. Okay, so these are our two variables that z is reliant on. And how do we write this down then? So if we were differentiating with respect to x, we would write this down like this. Okay, so dz dx we say in the same way as normal derivative, but of course now we've got these slightly stylized curvy curly d's. Okay, so this is what we call a partial derivative. So we've got dz dx, but it's a partial derivative, dz dx. Of course, we could also write then, if we're differentiating with respect to y, dz dy. So this is now with respect to y. So these are what we call first order partial derivatives. Okay, first order partial derivatives. Now, how do we go about finding these first order partial derivatives? So they're a little bit strange to begin with, but we'll get used to it once we do a few examples. Now, when we're differentiating with respect to x, so we'll deal with this one at the top first. When we're differentiating with respect to x, what we do is we treat y as a constant. Okay, so when we're differentiating with respect to x, we treat y as a constant, which can be a little bit confusing to begin with, treating letters as numbers. But like I said, after a few practices of these, it's not too bad. So we're differentiating this now with respect to x. So we're differentiating the x's here. So what we got? 3x squared. Now what happens to the y to the 5? Well, of course, you're treating it as a constant, but it is multiplied by the x's. So whenever we've got a number multiplied by x's, of course, it doesn't disappear. You might be tempted to say that the y cancels out there because we're treating it as a constant. But of course, because it's multiplied by x's, it stays the same. Okay, so it's the same as saying, you know, when we were doing normal differentiation, if we had, say, 4x squared and we were differentiating that, we would differentiate the x squared, wouldn't we? Which would be 2x, and then it would be multiplied by the 4. Yes? And then, of course, we get 8x. Now, this 4 here, this constant multiplied by the x's, didn't disappear, did it? We multiplied it into this, but it didn't disappear. So it's the same situation here with this y to the power 5. Of course, if you had a y on its own, and you were differentiating with respect to x, that would be the equivalent of differentiating a number on its own. And then it would cancel out. Okay, so slightly different when you've got letters on their own. And we'll see later on when we do some more complicated ones that some of them differentiate fairly easily. Okay, some of the terms differentiate fairly easily. So that is one of the first order partial derivatives of z equals x cubed y to the power 5. And just like with differentiation then, if I wanted to see the rate of change of z at these points, you would put then the coordinates of x and y into this here. Okay, so if I wanted to see the rate of change of z as x changes, I would put those two coordinate points into this derivative. So that's the first one. Now for the second first order partial derivative, we're now going to differentiate with respect to y. Okay, so we're differentiating now the y's. So remember, it's multiplied by the x's, so the x's don't cancel out. And now we're differentiating the y's. So what do we get then? 5y to the power 4. Okay, and we can leave it like that if we want, or to tidy it up, we could bring this 5 to the front and we get 5x cubed y to the 4. Okay, so these are now our two first order partial derivatives. What you've got to be careful of, as I was saying earlier, is that when you're differentiating with respect to x, you treat y as a constant. When you're differentiating with respect to y, you treat x as a constant. Let's have a look at the next function then. So we've got z is equals to 5x squared y plus 3y cubed x cubed. And we want to find the two first order partial derivatives. Okay then, so remember, if we differentiate with respect to x first, of course, it doesn't matter if you do x's or y's first, tend to do x first, I do. So we want to differentiate now the x's. Okay, so there's a quick way and a long-winded way of doing this, really. I'll do it the long-winded way first, just so we know where some of these numbers are coming from. So we're differentiating the x's first. So we've got 5. Differentiate x squared, we get 2x. Y, yes, so it's multiplied by the x's, so it doesn't disappear. Plus 3y cubed, and now we're differentiating the x cubed on the end, so we get 3x squared. Let's simplify this slightly then. So we got 5 times 2x is 10xy. Plus, we multiply this out, we've got 3 times 3 gives us 9. And then we've got y cubed and x squared. Okay, so 10xy plus 9y cubed x squared. So that's the first order partial derivative. Now let's go for the second one. So we've got dz dy. I was saying about, there's a quick way and a long-winded way of doing it. Of course, what I've done here now is I've differentiated the x's and I've put them into brackets just so it's clear to see what we've differentiated. Of course, you could go straight for this really by saying the 2 comes down in front. Yeah, we're differentiating the x's here. 2 comes down in front. There's a number there already, so they multiply. Yes, so just like normal differentiation really. They multiply, so we get the 10. Of course, take 1 off the x power, and you could just get x. And we can do the same here as well. Slightly weird because we've got the y term in between the number and the x cubed, but it doesn't matter, of course, when you're multiplying things together. It doesn't matter which order they're in. So we differentiate the x here, bring the 3 down in front. 3 times 3 gives you the 9. Take 1 off the power, and we get the x squared. Okay, so that would be the quick way of doing it. Right, so let's do the second first order partial derivative. So we're differentiating now with respect to y. So what have we got then? Differentiating this now. Always be careful, make sure you go back to the top question. Quite often I see people going back to this instead by accident. So we're differentiating now the y's. So we've got 5x squared. When we differentiate y, what do we get? So normally, of course, with normal differentiation, whenever you differentiate an x on its own, you would get 1, wouldn't you? Remember what I said in the previous video when we did normal differentiation. Whenever you've got a number times x and you differentiate that term, you end up with just the number. Here, of course, we're differentiating y's, but it's exactly the same theory. So when we differentiate y with respect to y, we get 1. Okay, so don't really need to write it in normally, but for this first one, I will. Plus, onto this second term, so we've got 3y cubed x cubed. We're differentiating the y's. So we've got 3, differentiate y cubed, which is 3y squared. And of course, that's multiplied by the x cubed on the end. Let's simplify this out slightly. So we've got 5x squared, multiplied by 1, so we'll leave that out, plus 9y squared x cubed. Okay, so there's the second first order partial derivatives. Okay, so again, slightly confusing. I can appreciate that when we introduce two terms on the right hand side. So we've got one variable here in terms of two variables on the right hand side. It can be a little bit confusing treating letters as numbers. But this is partial derivatives for you. It can be a bit of a confusing subject. One more example on these first order partial derivatives. So quite a nice and easy one, actually, if we find the two first order partial derivatives. So we want dz dx, first of all. So we're differentiating the x's here now. So what do we get? 2x. And of course, here now, we've got a y squared on its own, and it's not multiplied by any x's. So remember, what we're doing is we're treating the y's now as a constant. So when we're differentiating this y squared with respect to x, what do we get when we differentiate a constant? 0. Okay, so when we're differentiating this y with respect to x, because it's not multiplied by any x's, we're treating it as a constant, so it goes out. Okay, so we get just 2x then for that derivative. And it's the same, you can probably see what's going to happen. when we're differentiating with respect to y. Here we're treating x's as a constant. So differentiate this, it's not multiplied by any y's, so it's a constant on its own, which would be 0, plus differentiate y squared with respect to y, we get 2y. Okay, so of course then this partial derivative would be 2y. Okay, so always be careful when you've got x's and y's on their own. They tend to cancel out in one way or another when we're differentiating with respect to one of these variables. So as with normal derivatives then, we have first order derivatives and we have second order derivatives. With partial derivatives, it's the same thing. Okay, so we can get first order partial derivatives, as we've just been looking at. We can also have second order partial derivatives. Okay, so we're going to have a look at how we find these second order partial derivatives. Now, if we've got a function z initially, so just like we've had in the previous few examples where we've had z equals to x's and y's, if we've got a function of z, we can differentiate this with respect to x or with respect to y. Yes, so that's what we did in the previous few examples. And of course, remember what we had? We had dz dx and we had dz dy. Yes, so these were our first order partial derivatives. Okay, so remember with normal differentiation, how we would find those second order derivatives, is we would differentiate again. Now, it's a bit nicer, of course, when you can only differentiate with respect to one variable. Now, of course, we've got two variables, which makes it slightly more complicated. Now, sticking with the x's, first of all, then, to find another second order partial derivative here, we could differentiate here with respect to x again. Okay, so just like normal differentiation, really, I could differentiate with respect to x again. And we get our second order partial derivative. Okay, so written down very similarly to the normal second order derivatives. So that's one second order partial derivative. Now, going back to our first order, what we could also do there is we could differentiate with respect to y. Okay, we could differentiate with respect to y. So from here, I could differentiate with respect to y. And this would give us another second order partial derivative because we've differentiated twice. We've differentiated with respect to a different variable, but we have differentiated twice. So this other second order partial derivative looks a bit more complicated. Looks like this. Okay, so we've got d2z on the top and we've got dy dx on the bottom. Okay, so to remember which way round these go for this notation, if you want to get the notation correctly, what I always say is whichever one you've differentiated with respect to last here, so y in this case, goes first there. Okay, so these here now are two second order partial derivatives. And of course, we can do similar then on the other side. So we've got dz dy here, differentiated with respect to y. I can also differentiate with respect to y again. So you might be able to see where this is going. We've got d2z over dy squared. There's another second order partial derivative. Now, comparing to this side, remember what we did here is we also differentiated with respect to the other variable. So this is what we're going to do on this side as well. So from here, I'm going to differentiate with respect to x. Okay, going to differentiate with respect to x. And what we get is d2z over dx dy. Okay, so remember, always put in that last when you differentiated with respect to first on the bottom. And these here now then are our four second order partial derivatives. And we get a nice little thing here to tell us that we're correct with these two, because these two are always the same. Okay, so when you work these two out, they always come to the same terms. Okay, so that's a nice little trick in order to see if you've differentiated correctly. Okay, so what we're looking for then when we're finding these four partial derivatives are these four here. I can appreciate it looks complicated when you're writing it down like this, but when we see and apply this to a few examples now, hopefully it'll look a little bit easier for you. So here's an example then of another function where we've got two variables on the right hand side. So z is dependent upon two variables x and y. What we're being asked to do here now is find the four second order partial derivatives. Okay, find the four second order partial derivatives. Now, of course, in order to find the four second order partial derivatives, we also need to find the two first order ones first. Okay, so I always lay this out as I laid the last part out where I had all of the derivative notations down. So first of all, then I'm going to differentiate this with respect to x. Okay, differentiate with respect to x. So what are we going to get? We've got dz dx here. So let's have a look at our function then. We're differentiating the x's. So what have we got? 8x. Okay, so we've got 8x. Plus, now we're differentiating the x's here. So when we differentiate x, what do we get? 1. Okay, so this derivative here of x, we get 1. Of course, the 2 and the y stay there. So we're left with 2y. Okay, so we're just differentiating the x's. Now, we want to differentiate 3y squared with respect to x. And of course, we're treating the y's now as constants. So 3y squared is a constant. When we're differentiating with respect to x, it will disappear. Yes, so that will be 0. So there is our first derivative, and that is the first order derivative with respect to x. From here then, I'm going to differentiate with respect to x, and then later on with respect to y. So we're starting now to get our second order partial derivatives. So remember the notation for this, d2z over dx squared. And always remember to go back to the first order. Now, we're not going back to the initial function. And when you get down to the second order ones, they tend to be nicer terms in there, okay? So we're differentiating now with respect to x. So we're differentiating 8x with respect to x. Nice and easy. 8. Differentiating the y's with respect to x. Of course, we're treating these as constants, so that will disappear. Okay, so there is 1 second order partial derivative. Now, going back to the first order one, we can also differentiate with respect to y. And if you remember the notation for this, d2z over dy dx. Now we're differentiating this with respect to y. So 8x is a constant now. So you've got to be careful. Of course, we're flipping between x's being constants and y being constants. We're differentiating with respect to y. So x is a constant, so that will go out. And now we want to differentiate 2y, which is 2. Okay, so there then is our next second order partial derivative. Right, so going back to the initial question then, Now we want to do it the other way around, don't we? So we want to differentiate now with respect to y. So we're going to have dz, dy. Okay, dz, dy. So going back up to the top, differentiating with respect to y. Okay, so let's have a look at this then. Differentiating with respect to y, there's just x's in this term, so we're treating that as a constant, of course, so that goes out. Here, we're differentiating the y's, so when we differentiate y, we get 1 for y. Of course, it's multiplied by the 2x, so we get 2x multiplied by 1, of course. I'm not going to write that in here, but multiplied by 1. Plus, differentiate 3y squared with respect to y, bring the power down in front, we get 6y. Okay, so we've differentiated that now with respect to y. Right, now we need to start finding the second order partial derivatives. So we can differentiate this with respect to y again. So we're treating x's as constants, so that goes out. Differentiate 6y with respect to y. And we get 6. Okay, so that's that one. So that's another second order partial derivative. Going back to the first order one, and now we want to differentiate with respect to x. And we've got d2z over dx dy. Right, so we're differentiating now with respect to x. So 2x becomes 2. 6y, well, of course, we're treating the y's as constants, so that will now disappear. So we're left with this second order partial derivative as 2. And as I was saying earlier, of course, if you notice, the second order ones here are the same. Okay, so we found there now the 4 second order partial derivatives and, of course, the 2 first order ones as well for this function. So slightly complicated, I can appreciate it can be a little bit confusing, but yeah, this is what partial derivatives are. Let's have a look at another example then. So what we got, z is equals to 3x cubed plus 4x squared y plus 2y cubed. And again, we want to find the 4 second order partial derivatives. First of all, we're going to differentiate with respect to x to get dz dx. So what we got then, 3x cubed differentiated is 9x squared. Here we're differentiating the x's, so 2 comes down in front, multiplies by the 4. So we've got 8x, take 1 away from the power, of course, y. Okay, so 8xy. Here we've got plus 2y cubed. Of course, we're differentiating now with respect to x. So the y's will disappear as a constant. Okay, so nice and easy for that one. Right, now we want to find the second order partial derivatives. So from here then, we're going to differentiate with respect to x. So we've got d2z over dx squared. Differentiating with respect to x, so what we got, 18x, and we differentiate this, plus, so we're differentiating the x here, so we've got 8 times y, yes, because when you differentiate x, of course, that's the same as 1, so we've got 8 times y, so that's one of the second order derivatives. Now we're going to differentiate with respect to y. To get d2z dy dx. Okay, so differentiating with respect to y now, there's just an x in this term, so it's constant, it goes out. Here, we're differentiating the y's, so when you differentiate y, of course, you get 1. If we're differentiating with respect to y, you get 1. And of course, that's multiplied by the 8x. So we get 8x for that partial derivative. Yeah, so that's the other second order partial derivative. Right, so halfway through. Now we go back up to the original function and we want to differentiate with respect to y. So we get dz dy. Okay, so differentiating with respect to y now, this is a constant. So that goes out. Plus, so we've got 4x squared. We're differentiating with respect to y, so this y will be 1. So we've got 4x squared. Plus, differentiate this with respect to y, we get 6y squared. Okay, so there's a first order partial derivative. Now, of course, differentiate by y again to get another second order. So differentiating this now with respect to y. This is a constant because it's got x's in, goes out. This is 12y. Okay, so nice and easy. And that is another second order. And now last one, of course, we can differentiate this also with respect to x to get d2x over dx dy. And what do we get? So we're differentiating now with respect to x. So differentiate this, we get 8x. Differentiate this, of course, we've only got y's in this one. So this is a constant, so it goes out. So therefore then, we've got our last second order partial derivative. And of course, these are the same, which doesn't necessarily mean you're right, of course. But if that happens, it would have to be, quite a fluke to get these the same and it not be correct. So it's quite a good chance that you've got it correct if they are the same. Okay, so they're the four second order partial derivatives to this function. Another example then, I can appreciate these can be hard to grasp sometimes. So let's differentiate this first with respect to x. So we've got dz dx. So we're differentiating the x's. So here we get 24x cubed. So nice and easy for that one. Generally, when you've got x's and y's on their own, like this or like this, it usually makes it nice and easy because either we're differentiating them, as normal, or they're becoming constant, so they're going out. The ones that are a bit of a pain to us usually are ones like this, okay, where you've got x's and y's multiplied together. So 24x cubed. Differentiating the x's here, so we've got minus, differentiate the x's, 2 comes down in front, so we've got 2x, and of course the y cubed will stay there because it's multiplied by the x's. Differentiate this 2y squared, of course we're treating that as a constant, so it goes out. So that's the first order one. Now we want to differentiate by x again, d2z over dx squared. Now we're differentiating this with respect to x. So power comes down in front, multiplies by the 24. So 3 times 24 is 72. Take one off the power. Minus, we're differentiating the x's here. So differentiate x, you get 1, multiplied by the 2 in front. So it's just minus 2, y cubed. Okay, so there's 1 second order partial derivative. Now we go back to the first order one, of course, and we now differentiate with respect to y. Okay, so that gives us then d2z over dy dx. Now we're differentiating with respect to y. Here we've just got terms with x's in, so this is a constant, so that goes out. Now we're looking at this one. So we've got a minus and we're differentiating the y's. Okay, so this 3 here now is coming down in front. There's a 2 there already. So we've got 6xy squared. And that's the second order partial derivative. Okay, so you could do that the long-winded way as I showed you earlier. Minus 2x multiplied by the derivative of this, which is 3y squared. and then multiply them out. But just remember, the quick way, just like with normal differentiation, power comes down in front. If there's a number there already, they multiply. Okay, so you get that second order partial derivative straight away. Okay, so that's the two second order partial derivatives. Now let's do the other ones. So we can differentiate with respect to y first to give us dz dy. Okay, so looking up at this function then, the initial function, this is a constant because we're differentiating with respect to y. Here, we're differentiating the y's here. So what have we got? That's 3y squared. So it's minus, first of all, of course, here. And this is 3y squared. To make it tidy, I'm going to bring the 3 to the front. Okay, so we've got 3x squared y squared. Okay, so, yeah, you could write that down as minus x squared multiplied then by 3y squared. But generally, when you've got numbers multiplied by algebra, you bring the number to the front, okay? No difference, really. It's just it looks a bit tidier. Plus, we're differentiating this now with respect to y, so that becomes 4y. Right, so there's the first order partial derivative with respect to y. Now we're going to differentiate with respect to y again. So you got d2z over dy squared. So we're differentiating now this with respect to y. So we got we differentiate with respect to y, of course. This 2 comes down in front. So it's minus 6. The x squared stays the same. And of course you take 1 off the power of the y. Yes, so this 2 has come down in front, multiplied by the minus 3. So we've got minus 6 x squared y. Plus, differentiating this with respect to y, we just get a nice and easy 4. So there's another second order partial derivative. Last one then, let's go back to this first order. And now we can differentiate with respect to x. Remember then, this gives us d2z over dx dy. So what do we get then? We're differentiating with respect to x. So this power comes down in front here. So we've got minus 6 x, taking 1 off the power, of course. We've just got x's, just got an x on its own. Y squared, yes, because that's multiplied by these x terms. Differentiating 4y with respect to x, of course that's constant, so it goes out. So there's our other second order partial derivative. Okay, and again then, these two are the same, so they look about right. Okay, so two second orders here, two second orders here, and we've got one first order here and one first order here. For this function. Okay, so as I've been saying previously, it can get a little bit confusing, but I've got a few more examples and I'm sure it will be clear if it's not already for you.